Aloha. My name is Andy. In this video, I will show you how I managed to recover a Gigabyte motherboard that was stuck in an endless DualBIOS restart loop. So, a friend of mine sent me a photo of his PC. It kept freezing on this screen. And then restarting again. And again. I never seen this issue before, so it felt like a challenge. When I got my hands on the system, I confirmed the same thing. Stuck on the DualBIOS screen, constantly restarting. The motherboard in question is a Gigabyte GA-H77-DS3H socket LGA1155, a board that comes with DualBIOS. Now, here is a quick rundown in case you are not familiar. DualBIOS means the motherboard has two BIOS chips on board, a main BIOS and a backup BIOS. Normally, the system runs off the main BIOS. But if that BIOS gets corrupted or damaged, the backup BIOS will take over on the next system boot and copy the BIOS file to the main BIOS to ensure normal system operation. But unfortunately, that didn't happen here. My guess? A power surge might have hit it, triggering a protective lockout. So, here is what I tried. First, I disconnected the power and removed the CMOS battery, and left it out for 24 hours. I was hoping this would reset the system and fix the problem. No luck. Then, I took the motherboard out of the case, connected only the power supply, mouse, and keyboard. I also copied the BIOS file onto a USB flash drive, hoping the board would detect it and reinstall automatically. Still nothing. Finally, I came across a tip online. If you short pin 1 and pin 6 on the main BIOS chip, it forces the board to boot directly from the backup BIOS. The pin 1 is the one closest to the little dot on the chip. But here is the tricky part, the chip is tiny, and the space between pins is even smaller. So you have to be extremely careful not to shift the wire and risk damaging the chip. Here's what I did. With the system powered off, I cleaned a thin wire, carefully aligned it to short pins 1 and 6. And then used a screwdriver to power on the board. Take extra care to ensure the wire does not come into contact with adjacent pins. For safety and ease of access, it is strongly recommended to remove the motherboard from the case before performing this procedure. Boom, the recovery window appeared. But, nothing was copying. I waited a few minutes, still nothing. I shut it down and tried again. Same thing, the recovery screen showed up, but no copying. At this point, I was pretty disappointed. I honestly thought the chip might be fried. But I didn't give up. I tried one more time. This time, I used a sharp-tipped tweezer to short the pins instead of the wire. And guess what? It worked. The recovery process finally started. At last, the backup BIOS began transferring the files to the main BIOS chip. The recovery procedure from the backup chip takes approximately 2 minutes, after which the system restarts. This is the moment of truth, the motherboard is restarting, which is why the capture card isn't receiving any video signal. After 2 minutes and 23 seconds, I finally managed to restore the BIOS. Here I have three options. Load optimized defaults then boot. Load optimized defaults then reboot. Or enter the BIOS setup. I'm curious which version was restored, so I'm going to enter the BIOS settings. The restored version is F6. This version is no longer available on the motherboard's official website, where the earliest downloadable version is F7. Now the motherboard can be mounted back into the case. For system stability, it's recommended to update to the latest BIOS version. Since this is an older motherboard, the default HDD setting is IDE, and it will probably need to be changed to SE to avoid errors when booting into Windows. I save the modified settings, and the computer restarts. The Windows loads, and I check the BIOS version again in system information. It is version F6. Now I am going to download and update to the latest BIOS version for system stability. I go to the support section, where I can download drivers and BIOS updates. I select Windows 10, 64-bit as the operating system. Then I open the BIOS tab and download versions F7, F9, and F10 one by one. The BIOS update files were downloaded to my desktop. If you're looking for them, you should check your downloads folder instead. The files are 7-zip self-extracting archives. I double-clicked the F7.exe file, which opened a new window. In that window, I clicked the extract button, and three files were extracted to the desktop. autoexec.bat, fiflash.exe, h77ds3h.f7. I tried running fiflash.exe and autoexec.bat as administrator on Windows 10 64-bit, but unfortunately, that didn't work. Next, I use Total Commander to copy the F7 BIOS update file to the root of the C drive. After that, I extracted the content of the F9 and F10 BIOS update archives as well. I'll leave a link to the 7-zip program in the comments section for anyone who needs it. Then, I copied only the extracted files from the F9 and F10 updates to the root of the C drive and restarted the PC. Upon reboot, I entered the BIOS by pressing the delete key during startup. Inside the BIOS, I located and clicked the Q-Flash button. The Q-Flash utility opened after I confirmed by clicking yes. I selected update BIOS from drive, but since my C partition is formatted as NTFS, Q-Flash could not detect it. So, I plugged in the USB flash drive formatted as FAT32, which I had previously used for a BIOS recovery attempt. After entering the Q-Flash utility again, the USB drive was recognized as a mass storage device. I selected it, and the F7 BIOS update file was visible. I chose the F7 file. Q-Flash verified it and prompted me. Are you sure you want to update the BIOS? I clicked yes. The update process began and completed in about 2 minutes, after which I restarted the PC. Upon entering the BIOS again, I confirmed that the BIOS version had successfully been updated to version F7. If this video was useful to you and do you want to reward me with a cup of coffee, you can do it by clicking on the link in the description, select one cup and click on the support button. Thanks for watching, don't forget to share, comment, like, and subscribe. See you next time, goodbye.